On more than one front, we have dueling speeches tonight. Moments into Tom Barrett's speech, the governor started speaking to his supporters.
That's right. Let's hear what he had to say out in Waukesha in his campaign gathering.
You know, well, thank you. First off, I got to tell you, a week ago tonight was the 20th anniversary of the first date I had with Tonette. I thank God every day since then. And I knew that night I was going to marry her. It took her a couple months to figure it out. And thank God for that, because he not only blessed me with 20 years with this beautiful woman, but blessed us even more abundantly with two great sons, Matt and Alex, who are standing right here behind us. As Tonette mentioned, we've been crisscrossing the state, not just the last couple days, but the last 15 months. And I got to tell you, it amazes me everywhere we go, not just at rallies like this, not just at campaign stops, but in factories and farms and small businesses all across this great state. There are people who ask us all the time, Governor, how do you and your family put up with this all? And I got to tell you, it's simple. It's because every time we go to a factory, just like I did yesterday, every time we go to a farm or a small business anywhere in this state, there's people who come off the line and come up to us and say, Governor, we're praying for you. And that just means the world to us. And we thank you for that support. Tonight, I thank you for those prayers. I thank you for that support. I thank you for the vote that you cast for me today overwhelmingly across the state of Wisconsin, this primary election. And I'm asking for your vote on June 5th for me, for Rebecca Clayfish, and for four brave state Senate candidates. You see, there's a good news story to be told all across the state, because our reforms have helped the taxpayers of this state save more than $1 billion. Our reforms have helped lower property taxes on a medium-valued home for the first time in 12 years, and we're going to keep lowering them as long as we're in office. Our reforms have helped the people of this state, the hardworking people of this state, create more than 15,600 new jobs in the first 3 months of this year alone, and we're just getting started putting people back to work. You know, and just last week, another one of those rankings came out of the best and the worst states to do business in. You know, for years, long before I was governor, we were in the bottom 10. The bottom 10. Last week, those rankings came up, and for the first time, Wisconsin finally broke the top 20. We're not down yet. We're putting more people back to work. But you know what? In the story about that survey and the surveys we've seen from across the state, as much as employers, as much as small business owners appreciate the direction we've taken to move this state forward, you know what their biggest concern is? That things might change on June 5th. And see, really, for all of us, you here and everybody back at home, that's the real choice that voters will have 4 weeks from today. Do we go backwards or do we go forwards? Do we go back to the days of double-digit tax increases, a billion-dollar budget deficits, a record job loss? Or do we take the positive foundation that we built together to move Wisconsin forward? Tonight, I ask for your vote, not just for me, not for this office, but for people like Matt and Alex and every other kid and grandkid in this state, because that's what this is about. It's about not moving backwards, but giving them an even better future than we have here in the Wisconsin today. We have some real choices before us. Do we go back to the days for the last 3 years before I was governor, where we lost 150,000 private sector jobs when Jim Doyle was the governor? Do we go back to that? Or instead, do we look and take the approach forward that we built together with our reforms, that over the last 3 months in this new year of 2012, we've helped build 15,600 new private sector jobs? I say we go forward. Do we go back to the times that we see happening right before us? The lieutenant governor talked about it. In the city of Milwaukee over the last 8 years, unemployment has gone up by 28%. Do we want to go back to that?
No!
Or instead, do we take the reforms that we built together to move Wisconsin forward so much so that the unemployment rate is the lowest it's been since 2008? Where do you say we go?
Forward.
Do we go backwards to the time when 2 years ago, when Jim Doyle was the governor? When our... You're getting ahead of yourself here. When Jim Doyle was the governor and employers were surveyed across the state and only 10% said we were heading the right direction, do we want to go back to that? Or instead, do we want to take the positive reforms we put in place to help the small businesses and employers of our state move forward so much so that those employers now today, 94% of them say we're heading in the right direction. Which way do we want to go? Do we want to go back? Do we want to go back to the days when years ago, when Jim Doyle was in control and Wisconsin had an average property tax increase of over $220 million? Do we want to go back to that? Or would we rather go forward with reforms that helped us lower property taxes for the first time in 12 years? Which way should we go?
Forward!
You got it right. On issue after issue, we don't want to go back to the days when manufacturers had to pay more for taxes than they do today. Instead, we want to build on those reforms that help lower the tax burden because of the budget we signed into law so that manufacturers are some of the fastest growing jobs in the country right here in Wisconsin. I say we want to go forward to move on in Wisconsin. Do we want to go backwards to the days when we're going to rehash the debate we've had over the past year?
No!
I don't either. I want to take the positive reforms that we put in place that have saved the taxpayers more than $1 billion at the state and the local level. And where are we going to go with those?
Forward!
And most importantly, do we want to go back to the days when a handful of special interests controlled our state and our local governments?
No!
Instead, we put in place reforms that rightfully put the hard-working taxpayers of Wisconsin in charge. We're not going backwards, we're going forward. But I need your help. I need your help for the next 4 weeks, because you see, since last February, those big government union bosses in Washington, the out-of-state special interests, have spent millions and millions and millions of dollars trying to take us out. First in the spring, then in the Supreme Court, then in the Senate recall elections, then in the recall itself, and again this year, they're pouring in tens of millions of dollars, and you ain't seen nothing yet for what they're going to pour in the state over the next 4 weeks, but we got a simple message for them. They can take their money. They can take their people and they can go back to New Jersey and Washington and Chicago and anywhere else they're from, because we run things in Wisconsin for the taxpayers.